don't you? Sit right back, and I may tell you a tale of three little pigs and a big bad wolf.
And we're back to bring you more shittiness. Today I got with me Bocage Royale and Dickus Khan today at the same time. How you guys doing?
Good, man.
Yeah.
How's school going and everything?
Oh, got pretty let low this year, but it's going well.
Yeah.
It's pretty tough, you know. First year university.
First year college for you, right, Dickus Khan, yeah.
Yeah.
Cool stuff. Yep. Me, second year, no school at all. Second year of my whole life. It's kind of freaky, but at least I get a lot of time to play video games.
Yeah.
Although, I wish I didn't have time to play this one, because overall, shit-tastic. Right there, that's... I could think of many, many words to describe it, so I won't even go on. This is the level we'll be beating today. Piggy Wiggy level!
Yeah.
Yeah, the music here is by Green Jelly, and it's called Three Little Pigs. If for you heavy metal fans, you're gonna get a lot today. A lot of songs about pigs. So I didn't know much about this level last time in the previous video, but there's not much to know. It really is trial and error with those doors. You just have to memorize the layout of the level. But there is an objective that I didn't even really manage to see last time, so I get that out of the way quick, show you how to get the objective, and then I try to beat the level, but it takes forever because it's a lot of a maze, basically. It's like a stupid maze with no map.
This is the least factory-looking factory you've ever seen.
I don't know. The layout's not terrible. I mean, gray tiles is kind of boring.
Oh.
Down I go.
And you died.
Mm-hmm. First death.
So this, a random hammer.
This still grosses me out. Everything about this level is very creepy.
Yeah.
But you have to get over it. You have to play through it.
What's he doing there? Is he a guard? Are they looking for you specifically?
Yeah, you got out. And now you're trying to free the rest of the pigs. They'll lose millions.
So instead, if a pig gets loose, they just kill it.
This is economics. They got it. If a pig's running around freeing the other pigs, their business plan, it just goes down
it's
the tube.
It's kill. Don't put it back in the game.
So here's
game.
A new
just
thing.
Just murder it.
Here's a new thing in the game. This is where you find the objective. These switches will make the keys appear, and the keys will open up various locks that have pigs in them that wouldn't open up before. So let's go find the one that the green key opens. So that's the next step. So it takes a while. New season of The Simpsons coming up next week.
I wonder if it'll be good.
Yeah, I don't mind watching new Simpsons. I mean, they're definitely not as good as the old, but you just go in. You go in. Here's what you do. You go in with absolutely no expectations.
Yeah, that's what I've had to do too. You expect it. Okay, I'm not going to laugh out loud once.
Exactly. Expect to maybe get zero laughs, no expectations. And then if something doesn't directly offend you with how bad it is, then at least you think it's a decent episode.
Yeah.
Unlike with this game, where you go in with zero expectations, I actually expected it to be shitty with the acclaimed Simpsons game so far, and it just took it to a whole new level of offensively bad.
Yeah. This shouldn't have been allowed to be released.
It should have been illegal.
Little kids are the main focus here, and that's what I keep thinking about. Is little
actually,
kids
censors probably should have had a look at this level. It really is disturbing. But, you know, you're freeing the pigs. And it's all virtual reality anyway. Yes. The classic first appearance of Naked Bart, I guess, by the way.
Yeah.
And, maybe this is where they got the idea for Spider Pig. Maybe Acclaim had a big part.
No way.
Maybe Acclaim had a big part.
That would be so trippy.
I bet that they had a big part in making the movie because they're so bad at making games. They just like knew that they could make the Simpsons movie.
Man, I don't understand your logic there.
Well, I didn't like the Simpsons movie, you see.
I liked it.
I don't know. Yeah,
it's fine.
It was okay.
I actually did like Spider Pig.
Yeah, well.
I thought anything that comes after the Simpsons movie, I haven't even watched the new episodes because it just butchers the old episodes.
I've seen a bunch, a handful of the newer ones, but I still watch the older ones more often. Because there's some real classics. After having played Bart vs. the Space Mutants, I went back and watched some of the ones that had been referenced, you know, the season one stuff. And, pretty funny. Pretty funny
so
how they
spawn the world in the level, and there's a guy with a flamethrower.
Yeah, it's all really
taser.
The level design is just so dickish, and the controls are just so hideous. They make like Kathy Bates look like Megan Fox, like shittiest controls. Some of the worst platforming ever. But I've explained all that, and I've shown all this. So speed up through this portion of the level.
Save the poor piggies going to their doom in nets.
Yep, I think we got Piggies by George Harrison coming up soon in the soundtrack too to fit with this. There's a lot of songs about pigs actually. There's a lot of pigs in like shows and movies and stuff too.
Fuck the police.
You guys like pigs? Yeah, fuck the police. I put in Kid Rock in the last one.
Yeah. War Pigs, Black Sabbath.
Yeah, that's pigs. In this video.
Yeah.
Really good.
Yeah.
Really good song. Yeah. I actually love that song.
Yeah. You'll hear that later. Like I said, for metal fans, it's been spoiled now, but that'll be coming up. So here's where you get the keys. I restarted the level because I gamed over. So now we can see that. Okay. Did I grab that key? I think so.
Yep, you got the key. You walked right into it, right?
There's the green lock. And yeah, I definitely walked into it and it disappeared.
Okay.
And now it's not in the inventory. So I'm like, wait, the key just disappeared. Like, so another dick move. Who designed that? Come on. I hate shit like that.
No, down the elevator, mm-hmm. up the elevator. I could just take the controller away right here.
Yeah,
and
give
it back.
You scratch your ass. So,
there it is.
It's true. If you walk into it with your face, it disappears. And you have to get it again.
You have to jump on top of it.
Don't know if that's even true for the other keys. That's the only time it would happen to me.
It's a glitch.
Boink.
Yeah! Pigling Bland.
Yeah, and now I have a sense for how to get the other objectives. The blue and red keys, at first I kind of thought what you didn't see was me flipping those switches for like 10 minutes, thinking there might be a code or something to make the blue and red ones appear. No, they just appear somewhere randomly in the level and you have to go find them. So, what I did was cut to finding them.
I like the blue key.
Yeah. It's like Commander Keen. You need the blue key. Or what other games had blue keys?
Doom,
of course. Just like... Yeah, I'm surprised there's no Doom ripoff in this game. Yeah. Doom has been ripped off so many times, and this is like the one shitty franchise that hasn't done it. So there we go.
They're affiliated with LJN, though, and they've ripped off Doom. The Bible games.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
LJN isn't responsible for Bible games. That's Wisdom Tree who makes Bible games.
Didn't they branch off of LJN?
No, they're from Color Games.
Oh.
Yeah. I think it's something separate. I don't know. This might This might spawn a whole bunch of posts in the thread about shitty game companies and how they're all affiliated with each other. There. See how, like, now I know where the red lock is, and I have to go exploring through these doors and to find it. I'll spare you some of that and sort of cut to a good route here. If you go through this door, this is the only door in the 1-2-3-4 room that'll take you not through the door that leads to it. It'll take you out of just a different door. So you can use that to your advantage and get the red key. So pigs in pop culture, yay or nay? You guys a fan of Charlotte's Web?
Yeah.
Like,
yeah, I enjoyed Charles.
I love Wilbur.
Wilbur's a
I don't
pig
even
character.
Squeak or squawk.
Wilbur's Babe. A great pig character.
Wilbur, I only saw the Paramount Pictures animated Charlotte's Web. Yeah, no, you know Charlotte's Web, though? I only saw the Paramount Pictures animated version. I never saw the new version.
Oh, yeah. Well,
yeah, I haven't seen the new one either.
Well,
yeah,
I think it's for a younger audience. I think ours is probably better. Paul Lind as Templeton.
Yeah.
Awesome.
It says crunchy.
What? Remember that? Hell yeah.
Smorgasbord.
Yeah.
The fair is a veritable smorgasbord.
So I got the gold key, if you didn't notice, from the same place where all those switches were. And you use that to get out. The gold key appears once you free all three other ones.
I love Gordy.
But the level's not over.
What?
What? You think we were done or something? Morons!
Why not? You got all the keys, you freed every pig, and you went out a crusty door.
But this, you guys have to understand, this is virtual Bart. This is the epitome of anal fecal matter. It's redundant. Notice. notice that. Okay. So this part of the level is actually the hardest part, too. There's
Those frozen pigs?
Yep. Encased in ice.
Disgusting.
They're just throwing them off the edge of the building?
Just try to stop
a perpetual motion machine is knocking them off of onto
It's like, quick, get the ice pigs. That'll stop them. They'll knock them right out.
So yeah, see, that claw machine grabs the pigs and drops them on me, causing damage and a little bit of knockback. It's a real bitch when you're trying to use this elevator.
At least you found the elevator.
Do they grab you?
Nope. I thought they might, so I avoided them for a while, but they don't grab you at all. Yeah, so I'm taking this elevator, doopity-doo, great level design. And you might notice there's a dead end here. That literally is a dead end. If you take that elevator, that's certain doom. It's like a trap.
Just takes you to death.
It's the wrong way. So what just you didn't see was me doing 10 minutes of going up there and falling into that cup again. Actually, I have created a nice...
Oh, secret exit.
This is the way you go. And we'll probably see a successful run, though, because I cut out a lot of death. And I'm going to leave it in for a death montage at the end of this video. So I hope you enjoy that. The music for that will be Mozart's Requiem in D minor. First three movements, at least. Okay. This is the worst part, because those pigs will fall down on you in a really badly timed way for when that elevator appears. So you can't get onto it, and if you try to jump onto it, you'll get hit with the pig at the same time, and miss the platform and fall straight to your death. You'll see that more.
And then there's that one last platform, you just gotta get past it.
Thankfully, I never died on that one.
Okay, I would imagine, like, if you would die on that one, you would just rage, just really throw the controller.
That's the kind of thing where you die at that part, and then you'd start again and die on the first hole like 8 times by accident because you just are out of rhythm.
Yeah, and you're totally just screwed up.
What is this ass? Look at his hat.
This next portion of the level, yes, it's still not over, is really weird. You gotta put that pig on that platform and push this button so that the claw grabs the ice pig and supposedly brings it into the furnace.
Why? You were saving them and now you're murdering them.
There you go. I got points. My score went up for that.
No!
And you have to do it 5 times. While this unkillable douche is running around spraying you with...
whatever it is.
Liquid nitrogen.
Yep.
And it freezes Bart and you die. Yeah, you can die if you get hit too many times. So there's some convenient corn on the cobs to heal you there. Get that corn out of my face! So you have to do this 5 times, which is why I sped it up. It's the exact same thing, and that guy is unkillable, as I said. Also resembles No Clown from The Simpsons. But we're past expecting that.
Oh, nice. Got one on the first try.
Yeah, I got that one. I found it quite difficult to time the button and the claw. Oh, it slowed down. Are we almost done? So yeah, you gotta get these. I don't know why you're doing this. Does this thaw the pigs out and then they're free? Because that's been your goal this whole time so far.
It must be, because if they drop down, they go on a conveyor belt and go somewhere else to get dropped off the side of the building. So they either go to the furnace.
Yeah, what happens if
you get dropped off the side of a building?
What happens if I wasn't there to push the button? What would have happened to those pigs? They just chill out? All right, so this is another part of the level. This is the furnace. I pointed to the furnace there, viewers.
So you sent the piggies to here.
Well, I don't know, but there's one in a cage, and it seemed out of the way.
You saved its life.
Didn't that seem like a weird place to put an objective?
Yeah. Look at that. Do you have no...
And you're getting hit by fire.
That's right,
below.
And with these smashers, they deal only a small amount of damage and stun you for a small amount of time. But you have no invulnerability frame, so you basically take 2 or 3 hits when you get hit by one. And another wonderment of level design. You'll see more of this in the death reel. You have to jump down. What the you have to jump down!
Down.
You can't see more than half the screen.
You know
what
would be nice? The Battletoads cable for this part of the thing.
You can't even see down.
There's no way to look down as far as I know. I didn't try the L or R buttons. And, because they didn't do anything in the other parts of the level. And look at that, you just gotta, like, pray you're gonna land on something.
Yeah, most of the platforms are either moving or not even there when you're coming.
Yeah. Oh! Look at that one! It's out! It's out!
You should have landed on it. Oh, there's Homer's.
Yeah, so that means I had to restart the level.
Eating pig Bart.
Yeah.
Yeah, we covered how gross that is already. That's scarier than anything that's ever actually been on The Simpsons, including Halloween specials.
Yeah.
Okay. When they actually turn Homer into hot dog meat. Yeah. In one of those. In, I think, a scene that's been cut for syndication.
I don't think I ever saw that one.
It's the same Halloween special where Homer sells his soul for
all
a donut.
All of them were in the
All
world.
Of them
Every
were in at the
one.
Same time! So
you just jump blind faith, hope one of them's out. None of them.
Oh,
one of them.
See?
Yes.
My strategy finally prevailed. When you have
Fuck!
Nope, you gotta walk in there.
Fall in between those two.
You
things.
Can't jump through there, you have to walk. It's just the way the game was designed, right?
Because you have to die there once. At least once. Probably seven times or eight times.
Depending on how old you are.
Wait, you can just walk over it? How a fucking piece of dog shit.
Oh yeah, AVGN references up in her.
Yeah. It's exactly what it's like.
Oh, this was a long time.
Except you don't die if you miss the jump.
No, you'll see a lot of Ninja
Turtles.
You just
have to go back and do it again.
Ninja Turtles might be harder than this, I don't know. It's hard to... I'd have to play it again. But this is definitely more tedious and frustrating because it's like all bait... I can blame almost everything on the game. That's another good thing about the game, though. It's almost liberating in a way. All of my failures in this game can be blamed on the game. It certainly makes me look... I guess there are people who've played this and mastered it, and good on you guys. You're masters. You're better at video games than me. Woohoo!
You're good at the worst game ever.
So this is still not over. We're in the office park of... We're in the office part, and we're fighting the bosses.
Ooh, it's gonna be a good boss.
Businessmen. I don't know.
Look at that Simpsons character.
You can stun him there, and the book will fall on. Yeah. The book hurts you too. What's causing these books to fall, you may ask? Why, that fat ass jumping.
On his couch.
That's a good point. How does he create a tremor when he's jumping on a couch? Yeah. Never even noticed.
Why is he jumping on
a
couch?
To hit
that's
you with
good,
books.
Good question.
He doesn't realize that's a common boss thing. The projectiles
hurt. Get the pig! I'm so angry!
This took
me, they're the managers of the store.
This took me
the
a lot longer. Burger. Lot longer than I care to admit to. So we're going to start seeing some sped up boss fight in a bit. Because it's pretty tough to stun them right under the bookshelf, first of all, while you're taking hits from the books. If you get hit by the book disappears before it hits them. So you gotta get out of the way. Also, there's no guarantee a book's gonna fall while you've stunned them there. Or fall in the right place.
So it doesn't matter how many times you jump on their head.
No, that just stuns them for a bit. So, away we go. See, the boss only jumps whenever he wants, too. As far as I know, you can't just instigate it. So, this guy took me a while. Look at that! No books!
Yeah, and sometimes no books will fall, like, you can't control that.
That's a pain.
What an annoying boss battle.
Yeah. And I lost a life, and I'm on my last life right now, and that would mean I'd have to restart the level from my save state at the beginning. Yep, afterwards you'll see some of the deaths. Probably most of them, if not all my other deaths. I think... I had 70 to 80 minutes of footage of this level. It's a real bitch.
Wow.
But I'm really determined at this point. This is the first time I've faced the boss, and I do not want to play the whole level again. Losing one life is enough, I think. And I should be able to get through it. There, he got hit by a lucky one, and I didn't even stun him that time. But, Jesus, like, that was three times speed.
Oh, right
that went right through
him. It went right down his nose!
You guys are now feeling it for me. Thank you for that. So, yeah.
It slows down
that
right
was
before it.
Three times speed, by the way. So you can imagine how.
Oh, got him. Boom!
Oh, nice.
So we got the final boss, who runs like a blue meanie from Yellow Submarine.
Blue meanie.
Seriously, what is with this guy's
blue meanie?
What is with this guy's walk cycle?
He does look like a blue meanie.
His legs are not attached to his torso properly.
Whoa, look at
him. They look a lot, yeah.
So there you go. You saw, if you get him to run up to you and jump like that, he'll make a book fall. So you gotta do it in the right spot. And this was a lot easier to me than waiting for him to jump on the couch. Because you can just, you know, figure it out. So we're almost done. This is the end of the level. We'll never have to see this abomination ever again. This won't have to scare you anymore, guys. You can go eat your hot dogs, eat your bacon, you know.
Like
pork products as you want.
Yep, piggling bland all you want.
Yeah.
With ribs.
Yay, you beat the boss.
That's it, that's the end of the level. The last thing you do,
pig level.
You go to the pig holding area, which apparently is in the Simpsons hallway.
Yeah!
Note the decor of the background.
Save every pig. Wow, the pig holding
We're
area.
Home.
You have no idea how relieved I was to get here.
It just feels good to save them all.
And there is some music you get at the end, so you'll hear it. Public domain. Thank you guys for watching. Enjoy the death montage. I'm used to saying meth montage because of Breaking Bad.
Breaking Bad!
Enjoy the death montage coming up. It's been Danzo of Lovington.
Dick is gone.
Bocatch Royale.
Death Be Not Proud by John Donne. Death, be not proud, though some have called thee mighty and dreadful, for thou art not so. For those whom thou think'st thou dost overthrow, die not, poor death, nor yet canst thou kill me. From rest and sleep, which but thy pictures be, much pleasure, then from thee much more must flow. And soonest our best men with thee do go, rest of their bones and soul's delivery. Thou art slave to fate, chance, kings, and desperate men, and dost with poison, war, and sickness dwell. And poppy or charms can make us sleep as well, and better than thy stroke. Why swell'st thou then? One short sleep past, we wake eternally, and death shall be no more. Death, thou shalt die. The Hollow Men by T.S. Eliot. We are the Hollow Men. We are the stuffed men, leaning together, headpiece filled with straw. Alas, our dried voices, when we whisper together, are quiet and meaningless as wind in dry grass, or rat's feet over broken glass in our dry cellar. Shape without form, shade without color, paralyzed force, gesture without motion. Those who have crossed with direct eyes to death's other kingdom remember us, if at all, not as lost violent souls, but only as the hollow men, the stuffed men. Eyes I dare not meet in dreams, in death's dream kingdom. These do not appear. There the eyes are sunlight on a broken column. There is a tree swinging, and voices are in the winds singing, more distant and more solemn than a fading star. Let me be no nearer in death's dream kingdom. Let me also wear such deliberate disguises, rat's coat, crow skin, crossed staves in a field, behaving as the wind behaves, no nearer. Not that final meeting in the twilight kingdom. This is the dead land. This is cactus land. Here the stone images are raised. Here they receive the supplication of a dead man's hand under the twinkle of a fading star. It is like this in death's other kingdom, walking alone at the hour when we are trembling with tenderness. Lips that would kiss form prayers to broken stone. The eyes are not here. There are no eyes here in the valley of dying stars, in this hollow valley, this broken jaw of our lost kingdoms. In this last of meeting places, we grope together and avoid speech, gathered on this beach of the tumid river, sightless, unless the eyes reappear as the perpetual star, multifoliate rose of death's twilight kingdom, the hope only of empty men. Here we go round the prickly pear, prickly pear, prickly pear. Here we go round the prickly pear at 5 o'clock in the morning. Between the idea and the reality, between the motion and the act, falls the shadow, for thine is the kingdom. Between the conception and the creation, between the emotion and the response, falls the shadow. Life is very long. Between the desire and the spasm, between the potency and the existence, between the essence and the decent, falls the shadow. For thine is the kingdom, for thine is, life is, for thine is thee. This is the way the world ends. This is the way the world ends. This is the way the world ends. Not with a bang, but a whimper. Lady Lazarus by Sylvia Plath. I have done it again. 1 year in every 10 I manage it. A sort of walking miracle, my skin bright as a Nazi lampshade, my right foot a paperweight, my face a featureless, fine Jew linen. Peel off the napkin, oh my enemy. Do I terrify? The nose, the eye pits, the full set of teeth, the sour breath will vanish in a day. Soon, soon the flesh, the grave cave ate will be at home on me, and I, a smiling woman, am only 30, and like the cat, I have 9 times to die. This is number 3. What a trash, to annihilate each decade. What a million filaments the peanut-crunching crowd shoves in to see. Them unwrap me in hand and foot, the big strip tease. Gentlemen, ladies, these are my hands, my knees. I may be skin and bone, nevertheless, I am the same identical woman. The first time it happened, I was 10. It was an accident. The second time, I meant to last it out and not come back at all. I rocked shut as a seashell. They had to call and call and pick the worms off me like sticky pearls. Dying is an art, like everything else. I do it exceptionally well. I do it so it feels like hell. I do it so it feels real. I guess you could say I've a call. It's easy enough to do it in a cell. It's easy enough to do it and stay put. It's the theatrical comeback in broad day. To the same place, the same face, the same brute, amused shout. A miracle! That knocks me out. There is a charge for the eyeing of my scars. There is a charge for the hearing of my heart. It really goes. And there is a charge, a very large charge, for a word or a touch or a bit of blood or a piece of my hair or my clothes. So, Herr Doctor, so, Herr Enemy, I am your opus, I am your valuable, the pure gold baby that melts into a shriek. I turn and burn. Do not think I underestimate your great concern. Ash, ash, you poke and stir. Flesh, bone, there is nothing there. A cake of soap, a wedding ring, a gold filling. Herr God, Herr Lucifer, beware, beware. Out of the ash I rise with my red hair, and I eat men like air. Dying is fine, but death, by E.E. Cummings. Dying is fine, but death? Oh, baby, I wouldn't like death if death were good. For when, instead of stopping to think, you begin to feel of it, dying's miraculous. Why? Because dying is perfectly natural, perfectly putting it mildly lively. But death is strictly scientific and artificial and evil and legal. We thank thee, God Almighty, for dying. Forgive us, O life, the sin of death. Thank you.